Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another exciting Propaganda Cast with me, your host, Imperial Dane, Master Propaganda, Hero of Psych, Defender of the Fatherland. We're off here to exciting 1v1 on Crossroads. Between the South, we got Matthew fighting here for the Soviet Union for the Second Guards Mechanized Corps with Lend-Lease. Got Motan Shock Rifle versus the North. We got Blitzkrieg fighting for Germany. Deutschland, the Feldherrnhalle Panzergrenadier Division with Spearhead, Jäger Armor, and Encirclement Doctrine, the Bulletins of Panzergrenadiers and Scout Cars versus Guardsmen, Mines, and Conscripts. So a bit of a mix there from both sides. The 2-2-1 here is actually a pretty decent one, since as a rule, mean every shot counts for more if only the coaxial machine gun on the 2-2 wasn't quite as bucked as it was. It will probably be even more effective. So double pioneer start here from Blitzkrieg with an MD42 following up with. So there's a double conscript start there from Matthew. Moving towards center east here, whereas we got, looks like, west and east here from Blitzkrieg in an interesting move. I mean, technically there's nothing wrong going for either fuel point, since in terms of distance they're roughly the same amount of points away. I mean, you need to grab 2 points and there you go, fuel point. It's just sort of in terms of how most things plays out, it sort of tends to be sort of more, you know, north gets the west fuel point, south gets the east fuel point. But right here, Blitzkrieg is not playing by the rules. More MD42s there for Blitzkrieg. In fact, first engage down here, we got Country Corps with the MD42 12 rounds per minute going above their heads and possibly into Sergei's arse as well. Yes, my buttocks! I plan on using those to sit on tiers once I looted one from the Germans. I've heard about these tiers. Wonderful things. Back in my village in Siberia, I had to sit on ground. Moving straight here for the fuel pump with the Pioneers. Conscripts down south and getting the Pioneers. Then before too much time, much support with the same type of problem. Where, there we go. We got a flank here from the Conscripts. Sharp move there by Matthew. We got a third Pioneer squad there for Blitzkrieg. So initial effort is spearhead by the Panzer Pioneer Company Feldherrnhalle. There you go. Conscript flank around here behind the MD42. MD42 needs to turn about here. But looks like it won't happen in time here for Blitzkrieg. And the MD42 is going to have to pull back here. Engineers moving in. They're going for the point here as well. We got more Pioneers moving up in the north as well. MD42 forced away. MD42, in fact, grabbing the cough point there. So interesting move here, going for both fuel points. Very risky move, and again, as you can see, sort of quickly finds himself pushed off one fuel point very rapidly. And might also struggle around the other one. Country engaging the Pioneers, MD42 marks him up closer. At the same time as all of this is happening, though, Blitzkrieg is going for his cough point for just to further make things miserable here for Matthew. Up here, tech up there for Blitzkrieg. A bit of a gentle fox opening here to MD42, three Pioneers into a swift tier 2. Using then Panzer Gunner sort of as the main infantry and then supporting that with 2-2-2's contract request and take further from the Pioneers MP40s. You need to deal with the Pioneers and they need to retreat. They need to get to chase it out of there. Come on, Ludwig, retreat. Come on, Blitzkrieg, get your men out of there. Blitzkrieg, you dumb cop. Yeah, they're going to get wiped right there. Blitzkrieg a bit too slow to react. There you go, White MD42 moving up there, setting up sandbags. 1-4-2 is now focusing every bit they can on the center of the map. Pioneers falling back, and no luck to make a nice company. Should probably get up as soon as possible, since that's what he's rushing for. Flamethrowers there pushing out the MD42, unsurprisingly rapidly. There you go, MD42 setting up here. Other engineers moving about, they need to stop them with the Pioneers. And there you go, Constant Fire from the MD42 getting suppressed in the south. Engineers still standing about, admiring their handiwork.
That was some good shooting, boys. Thank you. I learned it during the Civil War.
The enemy has taken our supply
system. Oh, gets the MD42. Gets the MD42. We can probably group ourselves. That's going to hurt there. Blitzkrieg a bit. What is he planning now, Mr. Blitzkrieg? What is he planning? But he definitely needs to plan a like to make us comedy as soon as possible. I mean, that I would say he's been a bit delayed, since he was clearly trying to rush for it, but he's not quite then able to actually push for it due to the loss of the Pioneers. And, you know, forced to use the other Pioneers for frontline duties. And he's going for the cop point again here. Setting up the MD42, setting up some sandbags under poor Ludwig's corpse, and apparently his foot somehow getting stuck in the sandbags.
The enemy has driven a wedge in our lines.
Please help me. No, Ludwig, you're dead. Please! No, you're dead. Stop crying about it.
Country exchange to the MD42 here, getting suppressed. Negative cover, not looking good there. At the same time, points being grabbed there. MD42 up to deal with them as well. Expecting a flank through here. Bold, sharp thinking there by Blitzkrieg. Nice tactical sense. Oh no, his ship's about there. Perhaps well, he might not try and move through there and actually go for the deeper flank. We can sort of see the Blitzkrieg's mind there is turning about. And there you go. First, the armor cars on the way here for Blitzkrieg. The 222s like to punch his spear wagons, which were, for the most part, generally by 1944-45 replaced with 251-50 scout cars. The 250C, as it was known. The C standing for, well, like, they commonly called it the Caesar or Caesar. Caesar? Something like that. I can't quite fully remember the pronunciation there. My apologies, I suppose. But basically, that was basically a 250 half track equipped with the same sort of turret and gun here as the 222. The 250 half track would overall by 1944-45 stop production as a half track itself and primarily be shifted over to, well, armored car production. But this one was stopped entirely. So some fun facts there. We got constantly being suppressed by the MD-42, but while going up to further sort of minimize the amount of maneuver room here, the Russians have been pushing out through here. That's going to force them to have to push out through here as well. To engage the gears, we're going for the call point. Sharp move there for Matthew. Sharp move. Instead of just focusing completely around here, he actually takes longer routes and actually harasses elsewhere. Very nice move there. Very nice sharp tactical thinking there by Matthew as well. In fact, two sharp players, if you will. Tank Group Battalion Command going up here for Matthew, who's probably gone for Lend-Lease. They have a popular Lend-Lease. The Deuce Curse, the Fuel Drops, the Conscript Pair Kits, the Half Tracks, and the Shermans. Comes there flanking past the MD-42, taking advantage of another unit being shot at here. Pretty aggressive play there, gets behind the MD-42, taking fire there from the Flamethrowers. 2-2s bringing from both sides to engage with their auto cannons and occasionally with their actual machine guns. Russians there being sent running back. And we got the first Panzer Grenadiers actually arriving here, the first bit of actual infantry for the Panzer Grenadier Division Feldherrnhalle, which by the time of the Siege of Budapest, which is generally a sort of really overlooked siege, despite being a massive one with a lot of troops going on there, was upgraded to a Panzer Division. Once it was broken there, it would be formed into a full Panzer Corps with two Panzer Division and a numerous series of regiments, including its own heavy armoured unit, which in fact it also had a small company, I think, in its Panzer Gunner Division and its Panzer Division. Fun fact. Which means it actually had Tiger tanks and the likes. Before two, they're reinforcing. Panzer Gunner D heading towards the centre, grabbing the fuel point here. Constantly exchange to the MD-42. And getting blasted. MD-42 falling a bit back here. Duska setting up, got to catch a lot of the troops here. Constantly falling. Going straight for the 2-2 here, which is trying to get away here. I didn't pull back enough time, and there we go. Damn it, engine bad news there for Blitzkrieg's 2-2. MD-42 getting suppressed, taking heavy loss there. Need to retreat here before it gets knocked out. And we got Panzer Grenadiers advancing straight into the morass there. Gun down, suppressed in a matter of seconds. Pinned even faster. Teptophan grenade there fails, and Unteroffizier Ludwig is dead. In the meanwhile, we got fuel head being grabbed in the west, taking advantage of Blitzkrieg's focusing on the east and the south centre to then push for the west. Sharp play there by Matthew. Dusko opening up in the 2-2-2. MD-42 nearby supporting. Up here, we got MD-42 making its way back towards the Kampfgruppe headquarters. And there we go, another Dusko there for Matthew. Flanking here the Dusko with the 2-2-2. Punch from Shane to the 2-2's pioneers here firing away. So reinforcing. Panzer Grenadier there for Blitzkrieg additional tough assault infantry. And we've got here surprise choice of this spearhead. Well, not too much of a surprise. He's got Tigers, he's got some other bits there. But of course, up to see if he goes for any actual surprises from it. And he does, he goes for the mortar half track here. A 257. Moving ahead here to support the other elements here at the front line. Points there being grabbed. As for Matthew, nothing yet there from his tank of tank command. Can't quite draw fuel again that since Blitzkrieg has been able to control the fuel points quite a bit there. So not too surprised that Juska getting suppressed. Heavily hit there by auto cannon fire. Pioneers, Panzer is sort of catching in on all sides. We got a massive push here for Matthew. Shane to the infantry, looks like he realizes that's kind of a bad idea. Pulls back in the meanwhile and he's been caught with the double 222s. The two scout car strike. Like greased lightning. Guns. Pioneers have pinned down, Panzer's moving up there. Might try for a bunker grenade, then again the question is, do they have the range to pop it through? There we go, looks like they do! decent hit. Mostly did structural damage there. But actually, in this case, had the slightly unintended consequence of actually opening up a hole in the wall for the heavy machine gun to shoot back at them with. Not so lucky there for them, but still, they're doing a lot of damage there. They do have more firepower at that point behind heavy cover. Conscious moving up there. We've got more half-tech there still firing away, having done a few kills. And MB4 doing flanked here by the conscripts. Matthew moving about into a bit in a horde. Need to be a bit careful with that. And we got a T-70 on the way there for Matthew. And the second guard's mechanized called the T-70 light tank. Oh, nice hit there with the mortar half-tack. More country taking losses. 2-2's flying away as well here. Almost got a wipe there. Country charging ahead. Full Ugra. Now you got further casualties. Further men dropping like big, fat, ration-speaking flies. As they get pulverized there, but the autocannon fire being delivered by the 2-2-2s. Another push here for the cop point, making use of the sandbags provided for him. Matthew has not wired it off at all. T-70 almost done. There you go again, cut off secured. Blitzkrieg here really sort of conducting some pretty interesting tactical play there versus Matthew, and overall just having fuel control there versus opponent, making good use of mobile elements, slightly blitzkriegy, if you will. There you go, constantly retreating. Need to get that 2-2 fix up, which is by the way, veteran 2. More veterans. Going to go 2-wipe, they could 2-wipe, you probably go 2-wipe. Of course not, the Cracks machine gun does not fire because again, it has issues basically sort of its aim, sort of it has its own cone within it, which is really tiny. I mean, for the most part, it won't fire anything, which means it's effectively not there, and rather undercuts a lot of the firepower of the 2-2. MD4 too far ahead here, not covered. He probably also expect the T-70 light. In that case, MD42 got wiped here by Matthew's assault there with the tiny tank of Terra. Engineers being suppressed. MD42 pinned. More tough deck flying away there. And we got fuel drops here for Matthew. Fuel from the Western Allies to fuel the Soviet war machine here. And the Allies did supply the Russians a lot of fuel and a lot of other things. German tanks, of course, but they were also provided with Churchill tanks, universal carriers, but also M10 tank destroyers, amongst other things, which are usually the bits that don't get talked so much about. I need to gather that the 2-2-2. We got Panzerix up here for the Panzer gonna deal it. But overall there, mate, I think a bit mistaken with this 2-2-2. Blitzkrieg perhaps getting a bit too overconfident there. Thinking he can push straight on to Moscow. Instead, he ends up, well, getting punched in the face here. Immediately losing his most veteran armored car there. Oh, well, perhaps not. The almost close veteran people still. Overall, not too happy situation there. Modifying way, they almost got the engineers. Close veteran, one final grenade goes off. Duska turns about. Pioneer standing right there. 2-2 pull back for repairs again. And we got tech up there for Blitzkrieg. He could actually soon go for some armor. Panzer is going to move forward, but still need to be careful that T-70 with only one 2-2 and some Panzer strikes here. His option for so quickly putting an end to it can be a bit limited there. 2-2 going straight for the Duska. Pioneer is flanking as well. Panzer needs to retreat. Luxuk! Shell! Ah! Come on, Blitzkrieg! Don't be silly! And the Panzer is trying to hunt down the T-70 getting suppressed. They don't have quite as best aim there. We should actually just move up the 2-2 closer. There we go. Good hit from the mortar half-tech. 8 kills. Svetchen 2-1. Some brutal fighting here between these two players here. The Feldhand Harley expertly charging in time and time again. Whereas the Russians make good use of sort of the map, size of the map, and other methods to sort of push back the Russians all to sheer force. Certainly some pretty tense play here from these two players at the moment. MT42 with the intended armor pin guns. Get the douche cut. But can he grab it, or should he just try and wreck it here with the 2-2 using its auto cannon to shoot through the tiny, tiny gun? Also, we got S-mines being laid down to cover the eastern fuel points. So, Paul McCoop, he could go for the Stuka to support immediately, or sprint, or he might end up with a Panzer IV here. Conscripts with light supporters. I mean, in this case, we can see now Matthew basically decides, all right, enough is enough. We change the axis of attack, an attack from a completely different angle, catching opponent off guard. In this case, of course, occupy the houses all of a sudden. He's not prepared for. So, very sharp play there by Matthew. Very sharp. Good tactical sense there. And all of a sudden, again, for example, the 2-2 is caught now. With a lot of machine guns there, using armor piercing rounds, so we'll quickly go through it. If you were to remember to use it. Looks like he doesn't, but still, overall, a lot of firepower there. Two machine guns, Panzer Grenadiers, and 2-2. This is likely moving about as the MD42 pulls back. Could also grab another Duska there, but there we go. Blitzkrieg is pulling up the Panzer IV. That's from Matthew. Starting here with some Panzer Grenadiers inside the small hut.
And the machine gun got wiped over the consequence, waiting by the cutoff point. For a nice move there by Matthew. Another wipe there on Blitzkrieg. And the Feldherrn Heilepanzer going to do short in the south. T-70 engage the Pioneers. Catch them in the minefield. But could you wipe there? We did see a wipe. Heavy losses here for the Feldherrn Halle as the Russians flank assault there. Oh, another Pioneer squad wiped. Huge casualties here for Blitzkrieg. Huge casualties. I mean, he's going to have an arm advantage soon in the form of the Panzer IV. But good lord. He's lost all of his machine guns, all of his pioneers. Crikey. Some brutal play here. Brutal Ostfront play. And there they go. Panzerkampfwagen Fierce summoned fourth here with the Pintelmark machine gun on the way there. To the two's going to need some repairs. Close to Vetsch in the free still. 257 with the halfway to Vetsch 2 with 12 kills there. Not bad. And they got Strafnicki. He's actually gone for the special. Oh, he went for it in the first place, but he hasn't used it. But now, yes. Interesting move there. But there you go. T-70 trouble with the Panzer IV. And kaput. Flanking here, the Dusk. But there you go. Contra crossing ahead. Therefore, the Panzer IV. Panzer is tightly covering up there. Going for the fuel point there with the minesweepers. Good work. No damage engine, not damage enough for the Panzer IV in the first place. Duska pushed away, taking mana loss there for the Panzer IV. He hasn't recruited that one in an interesting move. And I'm guessing Matthew is planning here for the M4C Sherman. Alright. The Lend-Lease Shermans are sort of riding with. About, I think, 2,000 sort of ones with 75mm guns and about 2,000 76mm versions. Little fun fact there. For those that were not aware, the Russian crews generally seem to like me, in part because they're much more comfortable than being in a Soviet tank, but also I believe because you had a better chance of getting out of one if you got hit. The T-34 had a lot of nasty sort of bits with it. The hatches weren't well placed, they had a tendency of jamming, and they were really just difficult to get up compared to the Shermans, which are spring loaded, meaning you pop them, you were out pretty much. So, little fun fact there. Little fun fact there. Mantra was there for Blitzkrieg. Obviously, worried about any act to bring up mines. We're going forward to the quick suppression. The Panzer gunner just tries to flank about there. And, oh, he has not prepared the Panzer IV. Damage engine. And there we go. We got the M4C Sherman out here for Matthew. Also called the M-Chap because, well, that's basically sort of how it roughly looked to them. Or so it could be pronounced that bit of the M4C. Fun fact. Or something like that, anyways. But there you go, two knocked out. Panzer is pinned down, being crushed here by the Sherman. Bad news there for Blitzkrieg. Another reversal, another setback. Clearly underestimated Matthew's tenacity. And further in the Soviet course. And the Panzer IV here, half track close to 214 kills. Sniper out now for Blitzkrieg. He could go for Stuk here, probably should go, because the Sherman here will have a higher rate of fire than the Panzer IV. In fact, it's almost the same rate of fire as the Stuk G. And gets more bonuses towards cutting it down, meaning a veteran to flee Sherman here fires faster than the veteran to flee Stuk G. Obviously, he doesn't have target weak point, but he does have other advantages, including more accuracy on the move and better anti-infantry abilities. Sherman here pulling back, gonna need some repairs. And another push here. Oh, the MD4 has not been recruited. Oh dear, and he pops a satchel charge on it, punishing Blitzkrieg. Almost punishing him for not doing it. Really, Blitzkrieg needs to get the MD42 back in action. Matthew striking back here with the second guard's mechanized core against the Feldherrn Halle. Panzer IV on the hunt here, halfway to Vetsch in a few moments. Just need another kill or two. MD4 applying a nice cover of area denial there against a nice turn of it versus infantry. He could try and use his mortar to, for example, incendiary bomb it out. That could be an option there for Blitzkrieg, or just regularly bombard it. Need to recruit the MD42 though, Blitzkrieg. Get it back in action. Strafnicki getting sniped, Panzer IV setting out again. Need to get that mortar off to go to another place. It's currently really exposed there, in fact.
I mean, there's nothing that's preventing him right now, for example, just beelining for the mortar after check with the Sherman, probably taking out in two shots, which again would be very fast, considering its rate of fire. There goes Storm, gets shots on the way there for Blitzkrieg. Pioneer's taking a nasty hit there from the Sherman. Should have been suppressed there by the way. And wipe! Oh no, another loss there for Blitzkrieg. Panzer IV then getting the Sherman. Patrick going off there as well. Looks like Matthew's a bit beyond his means, and there you go. Betty 2 for the Panzer IV. Shirt snap. Sherman down. Sherman down. Kaput damage in here, the Panzer IV. Half health, but makes it out of there. Not really anything else to really deal with it. Matthew there pushed too far ahead there without infantry support with his tank, and the punishment was swift and merciless. And flame throw engineers annihilated here by the Panzer Grenadiers as well. Still has to recruit the MG42 though. Runtree pushing up here in a larger force. You got VT2 on the half track. Stuart Panzer Grenadier moving forwards. Panzer 4 slow moving ahead, and there we go. Second Sherman there for Matthew. Veteran D2 gained increased lethality there. Russian infantry quickly getting gunned down. We even got the Veteran 3 Panzerjägers moving up there. Second Sherman slowly moving forward to the front line. Needs to be careful not to rush ahead again. In particular, now we've got Stuke here to support Blitzkrieg at the front line. Back at base, troop pushing out again. Stravniki, fresh country there for Matthew. Push as well, country caught here. Needs to repair that Panzer IV though. At least he's got the Panzerjäger supporting it, and the other Panzer Grenadiers overall forming up a nice tight knit force. But of course, he still made one mistake. His 250 mortar half track is very much exposed. Looks like he's realizing it, pulls it away, but will it be in time? Looks like it. Really pushing his luck there. And meanwhile, got a fuel drop there into Matthew's base. MD42 finally recruit. Just need to repair it as well. Matthew could consider fuel cash, for example, to help speed up further fuel income versus opponent. It's time here for the mid-game analysis in terms of damage. Blitzkrieg's it in terms of kills. Blitzkrieg's ahead. Army value wise, slightly ahead there, but it's getting closer there. Matthew sort of closing the gap in terms of resource float. Not much there in terms of points held though. Sort of between these. I mean, Matt Blitzkrieg, a nice pit here in the centre, but again, he got overconfident, I feel personally. So that would also be my interpretation. Whereas now, sort of Matthew sort of pushing back there, having, you know, caused quite a few casualties. So Blitzkrieg's lost a lot of machine guns, pioneers, and quite a few of his scout castello sort of brutal approaches. Then Matthew's now pushing back. They're sort of surging in. I'm still surprised he hasn't grabbed that second Duska just to make it harder for Blitzkrieg to move his infantry about. But right now, one of his priorities should probably just be securing as much fuel as possible, bringing up more Shermans. He could also consider supporting these with a single SU-76 just for a bit of sort of more longer range anti-tank firepower, but also a bit of artillery fire that way to sort of bombard some of Blitzkrieg's positions. Otherwise, mines would be some good choice there for Matthew. Then again, if he's setting up fuel, ammunition for fuel, I mean, he might not go for so many, but even a few here and there could do a lot for him. Another thing that might also be worth considering would be sandbags for his machine guns to make them a bit harder to push off for Blitzkrieg. Otherwise, Matthew needs to sort of keep trying to outmaneuver his opponent, try not to engage him head on, as that's generally not where he performs the best. As for Blitzkrieg, well, he's certainly lost a lot of ground. He needs to push back against Matthew. He needs to try and, I think, flank about him, catch him off guard, and that way wipe him off. He's really insistent on head-on assault. Lay down some smoke using the mortar after. He can lay down smoke screens as well to use that sort of push in aggressively. You know, get past the Sherman, get behind it, cut off the path in with the Panzer IV. Then as the Sherman's, you know, focus on the Panzer IV, moving the Stuke from the outside, and then sort of catch him in the trap, and then use the Panzer IV afterwards to sort of clear out the rest while the mortar after then directly supports with the infantry sort of following in as a second way. I mean, that's an option there. Otherwise, more Panzer IV-C or maybe another Stuke there for Blitzkrieg would not be a bad idea, considering there's probably going to be more M4C Shermans. So the more he can bring to bear against them, the better. He could go for a Tiger, but that's going to be, I think, deeply risky move, to say the least, considering that's going to be quite some time off then in terms of just resources. I mean, he can almost get two Shermans for every one Tiger there that he gets, and that's now of course counting how much fuel he could get for the Allied supply drops, meaning he could easily get out two Shermans before Blitzkrieg gets out one Tiger. So there's a bit sort of a thing there to be careful about there for Blitzkrieg in terms of the style he plays around there. More infantry, more Panzer gun idea, I think would also be a good choice, and try and apply more hurt to Blitzkrieg. Maybe another MG42 to help control the map as well there would be a good idea. And a part of me thinks maybe a half-tech as well to afford him more mobility, but also durability so he doesn't have to retreat what few units he has sort of all the time to reinforce. That would give him, you know, a bit more frontline presence as well. So that's something there for Blitzkrieg to consider. But let's return to the fight here. Panther getting the gain of the Sherman. Nice hit there. Sherman bounces off the front line of the Panzer IV. Pioneer's flanking in there. Stooping up support as well. Need to be careful. We got pinned by machine gun firing at the conscripts. Good work. Good hit on the Sherman. Good hit. Down to the tank grenade goes off. Does the two get another shot off? No, it does not. Penalty was about to get White Panther moving forward there, going to be suppressed by the MD42. Looks like that saves the day here of the Stravniki, though it's pretty damn close. Comes a bit of trouble. Pin my machine gun the Stuka, they're firing, getting a few kills there as well. And Dushka wiping out the Pioneers by the looks of it. This time though, Blitzkrieg does manage to save. There we go, excellent mortar from the half tack. Almost wipes him. Stuka moves up there to fire. Should fire. Except he has enlarged his fire, so it doesn't fire. Oh dear. Still, 22 kills on the Mortar. That's definitely proving to be a decent investment there for Blitzkrieg. And certainly fits the Blitzkrieg theme, that's for sure. Comes to them being engaged by Panzer Gun, Panzer IV firing in as well. MP4 too much on turnabout support there as well. Machine gun wiped, he could turn that as well against Blitzkrieg, but has failed to do so just like with the first one he wiped. More Pioneers for Blitzkrieg. Looks like he ended up losing them anyways. Shame. Or perhaps he lost another Pioneer squad.
Have access to additional battlefield options.
Back here, just being reinforced, healed. Another sent running here by the Panzer IV, closing in and being halfway to Vetch 23 and at the ace level there. More fuel being dropped in there for Matthew to supply more Shermans to the front line. Panzer IV, the opening on the engineers. Now to repair that Panzer IV, and there we go, first M4C moving ahead. Waits for the second, there you go. Two Sherman tanks now here for Matthew versus one Stuka, one Panzer IV, and of course the Panzer gun is in. So we got a Panzer IV in the way for Matt. No, cancels it. Is he really then going to go for the Tiger? I think two Panzer IVs overall now would allow him to push further ahead there versus Matthew instead of pushing back. We got the reconnaissance flight there going in from Blitzkrieg. Need to get that victory point there so we can continue to bleed there. There goes Sherman 3. Catching the Panzer gun. It's in a pretty bad position. Need to retreat them. Wuxuk. But there goes Stuka. Comes up for Deutschland. Patrick's there. Hitting. There you go. Retreat to the Panzer gun of the year. But Stuka almost knocked out here. Panzer forming from the other side. Can he get the hit there on the more wounded one? Gets the Sherman there. Cooks it up. Stuka goes in there. Pursues the hunt as well. Sherman just needs to get out of there. Panzer moving up as well. There we go. That's going to screen the Sherman there. Preventing them from pursuing it. MD42 there versus Dushka, which has been crewed by penal troops. And there you go, damage engine, the Panzer IV. Quite a harsh loss there for Matthew. Lost one shot, not really doing that much damage there to the enemy. He should have had infantry working with it. MD42 have been flanked by conscripts up here. We got points being grabbed as well. We got a half tank there. A lot of trouble close to Vetchin 3. But another anti tank grenade there. I think he's going to go up in flames. Stuka running to support here. Pin machine gun firing away. Panzer supporting as well. And there you go. Pushed away. Damn close there for Blitzkrieg.
Our lines of supply are disrupted.
Damn close. Panzer IV rolling about here. But damage engine. Conscripts and the Sherman there going in. But we've got Stuka supporting. Stuka is supporting. Several penetrating hit there. One more hit. That's veteran from the Stuka. And there you go. But not enough time for target report. The Panzer IV is down. He should have prioritized repairing it, to be honest. But there you go. He didn't. And that's the result. A veteran Panzer crew lost in service of the Fatherland. They were heroes. And now he's going into the Stoop trying to get that Sherman. He needs to be careful if he gets hit by a mine or anything. That Stoop's going to be a lot of trouble. Of course, we know there aren't any mines, but from Blitzkrieg's perspective, you know, he needs to be careful. Up here, half track, just hanging back. Consul's pushed back. MG42 moving up as well. And Blitzkrieg's definitely playing for the target, taking the Molo is going for Panzer Grenadier and a Pack 40. Looks like the flit of the infantry Shermans is causing him to sort of consider more into a tank, but also a bit more infantry suppression in the infantry, I well imagine. With the loss of the Panzer IV, while he waits for the Tiger, the Tiger. Part of the Panzer Company Feldherrnhalle. Which, as a fun fact, didn't have any, I think, of its elements sort of really numbered. Which is generally how they go, they were all named, you know, Feldherrnhalle. Fun fact. Pack 40 out. He could end up cancelling those Panzer Grenadiers just to be able to get out that Tiger faster. Incendiary round here from the mortar half track. Ah, Pioneers wiped. There's so many Pioneers there. Can't imagine the Italian commander, the Panzer Pioneer Abteilung Feldherrnhalle is entirely keen on that. But there you go again, another sort of quick shift here from Matthew, instead of just trying to barge through again. He now again switches for the west side and quickly sets up here. Once more pushing for the carpon here for the road next to his base with armor infantry. Nice tactical shift there again. Once more forcing then Blitzkrieg to have to try and counterattack him rather than attacking into him. There's a good work there. Good work by Matthew. Thumbs up there, some sharp Soviet play. But of course, he's still got Panzer Grenadier and the mortar after there to contend with and other elements, so of course, it's not going to be that straightforward. But it certainly disrupts Blitzkrieg's set of mind there, and overall force him sort of, you know, have to deal with something completely beyond what was expecting. Veteran 3 Panzer is being mowed down by an almost veteran 3 MG42. Sherman also joining in. Kanska's wiped though. And there you go, another Sherman. Stukman's hit, he's careful. Forsyk misses. Heinz, you dumb cop. Damage engine, remember to use target weak point though, Blitzkrieg. Target weak point. Panzer gonna be moving head on here. Bit risky. Thankfully, Matthew does not have machine guns and his Shermans to pay for. Well, more Shermans. Meanwhile, we got a flank here from the Sherman behind the Stuk. Sharp work there, sharp work. Bit risky, but again, here's the thing though. Blitzkrieg with all this Panzer gun, he's lots of access to Panzer tricks, but he's completely lacking in Panzerfaust. In this case, there's also Pack 40 set up all the way here, so his Sherman was basically running straight into kill zone to get the Stuk. Not really cost-wise worth it. Tiger up here for Blitzkrieg though. Bring it. Holy crap, someone just went flying there. Look at me, Petrov. I can fly. Or could have been a German, I don't know. Look, Dieter, I'm so Luftwaffe. Completely useless. Anyway, Panzer's then each retreat, and that's pretty schnell. More fuel being dropped in there. We can see now that Blitzkrieg is quite on the back foot once more. Underestimated Matthew, and Matthew was quick to take advantage here of any sort of lull to quickly shift everything. Catching the mortar track here again. Blitzkrieg needs to be more mindful with it. Veteran Fee though, 27 kills. Quite good work there with it. Pin my machine gun all the way on the pants. The Tiger here. Flying away there after the conscripts. There for the conscripts. Dushka there standing up, manned by Stravniki. Quite a bit of firepower there in their hands. Grabbing pawns as well. Blitzkrieg very much at the back foot now. Very much. And still not repairing the mortar half track. Which has turned out to be a surprisingly good investment there for Blitzkrieg, really, when you think about it. And we got more recon so flight probably sort of suss out what is Matthew doing and if he's sort of preparing for another attack, say, through here or here. So nice move there by Blitzkrieg. He's paranoid about his opponent, he wants to make sure of everything. Tiger that moves ahead here. Catches a few snot-nosed penal troops there. Continues the slow advance there. Panzer is pinned down by the Vetsen to the MG42 there. Retreat the Panzer Grenadier. Schnell. Blitzkrieg! Ah, bollocks! Also, what happened there, by the way, is you that all of a sudden, even before the retreat, the sun is suffering a lot more damage. The thing is, with pin, it only gives the sort of damage protection for a brief period of time before it wears off completely, in which case the MU42 then, or any machine gun, does full damage to the unit. And that's basically what happened there. Blitzkrieg wasn't paying attention, all of a sudden his panzer gun is there, were taking full damage from a veteran deflee MU42. As I'm sure you can imagine, the result was not pretty. Duska there, but caught out. Oh, Gate moving his force ahead. He's not quite paying attention there. Careful, Blitzkrieg force. Ah, oh, scheisse. Need to retreat all of this. Button grenade off, though. Can he pull it off here, though? Still think not. And there we go. We got a full retreat here. Matthew close to another Sherman here. He's saving himself quite a few armored losses, though Blitzkrieg has not been without his losses either. Though his are mostly in the infantry department. Whereas Matthew's been able to maintain a more cohesive force there for a much longer. We can see, due to sort of Blitzkrieg's previous sort of decisions on his part, really forced to use the Tiger a lot more on his own, just sort of hold back the Russians here. Tactically strong, but on his own, strategically, it's not so strong. There goes Sham going after it. More puns are going to do there for Blitzkrieg, damaging the Tiger. Needs to turn about the Pack 4 to support, at least cover its flank. Sham trying to engage from the front. Not the best decision there, by the way, by Matthew. Need to pull back the M4C Sherman. Another Sherman away there for Matthew. Almost got it. The Sherman there with the Tiger and the Pack 40. Unit wiped, though, by the Tiger. 15 kills, closing in the veteran to one there. Feldherrn Harley desperately keeps firing on. Another Sherman goes hit. Pack 40 needs to stop. Schnell fires a Panzer out there, Kanone. Sherman down to half health with shank flank back. There you go. Panzer gonna be covering here as well. A nice idea here by Matthew, but without sufficient reconnaissance, he does know what's waiting him. Oh, we got another Pioneer Squad though. Another Pioneer Squad. So that wasn't two half bats, since that means he's once more Tiger's gonna be delayed in repairs, half health, damage engine, and he's gonna have to spend more manpower than to get it fixed up. And even then, that's gonna take long. So overall, it means that Matthew can, for the longer time, actually control the map here. Victory point wise, Blitzkrieg is quite behind Matthew at the moment. We've got mines here, back of base, troops reinforcing, turn being repaired. And there you go, trying to catch here the mortar half-tech. 32 kills, not bad at all. Veterans run for the Tiger, not bad either. There you go, Panzer's here, caught by Strafniki and the M42 here. It's retreat for one, Swooksook! So right now Blitzkrieg is very much on the reserves there compared to sort of how things were about roughly around the half point there, but a bit forward actually, the half point there. Going the victory point here, the fuel point in the east as well. Pretty interesting fight here between these two players. A lot of maneuvers, and not so much just, you know, blasting away each other, sort of head on. More fuel there for Matthew. Another M4C on the way. Tiger slugging ahead. Also, one common worry for Tiger crew was actually having their radiators damaged. If they had that damage, the Tiger was pretty much dead, since the engine basically produced so much it would burn itself up pretty quickly. So that was one of their bigger worries. In fact, one King Tiger in Arnhem actually got knocked out because the mortar round hit his radiators, knocking them out. A little fun fact there. Tiger halfway fixed up. We've got a Sherman wing up. Ooh, nice hit there for the mortar after again. 37 kills. It's really paying itself off there for Blitzkrieg. I mean, it's so rare you actually see mortar after, in particular one versus one, yet here we are from Blitzkrieg. And again, reasonably Blitzkrieg, you're just doing quite well with it. I'm quite amazed, impressed. Well, not amazed, but impressed. Impressed, sort of, I think is the more proper word here. Like, finally down more mines, and there you go, another Sherman out for Matthew. Another Sherman. Seems like he's not going for, say, any 76s, or maybe a half-tech to support his troops either. 30 kills on those Panzer Grenadiere. Enemy forces capturing supply sector. Tiger finally got two again. Double Pioneers here for Blitzkrieg. Going for the victory points in the west as well. But we've got the Sherman moving up there to deal with that.
Supply sector under attack.
Like 40 Panzers are pushing back. The Sherman also got the Tiger moving in there. At the same time, the flank will be exposed here to another Sherman. Slight collapse on the right flank for Matthew, but he gets behind Tier Blitzkrieg in the west. There you go. Gets behind the Tiger. Good flank there. Good flank there by Matthew. I mean, most people have just gone straight for it, but again, no. He took sort of path here. Then here, right behind the Tiger, actually getting off several hits there. Of course, also forcing Blitzkrieg now to have to worry about his flank and rear. Nice move there. Did double duty there with a single Sherman. Now that's sharp play there. That is sharp play. Seems like though Matthew's intent on then reversing it by throwing away his other Sherman. Nope. Pulls away there. He was trying to get the pack forward there, but didn't quite work out, but still realizes in time and pulls away there without necessarily throwing away the Sherman. Good move as well. Oh, Tiger hits a mine. Tiger hits a mine. Sherman though loses its main gun. Tiger though is heavily damaged, but close to vicinity too here. And we got another Panther 4 there on the way for Blitzkrieg. Using all his conscripts to repair it. So of course with the then leads his conscripts to get repair kits, allowing them to fix up the tanks.
Enemy forces are attempting to capture our territory.
Panzer Grenadier moving about. Once they're being grabbed. And we got aerial reconnaissance from Blitzkrieg once more again, so trying to suss out things, perhaps to ensure he doesn't get surprised like that again. But I'll probably also sort of help making sure this again, so he has a chance. In case, you know, they go after the Tigers, are probably pulling into safety further, or just sort of at least prepare to face the enemy head on. But there you go, Panzer IV was down there for Blitzkrieg and the Feldherrnhalle. Bits of three mortifiers. Oh! Almost a full wipe there, but the Panzer Grenadier should be able to finish it off there if they do pay attention. There you go, bit of a loss there for Matthew. Second guard's mechanized. Tiger almost fixed up. Matthew almost ready with another. Well, he just needs to grab the fuel crates here. He can call in another Sherman, in which case he's going to have three Shermans there versus one Tiger close to 52 and a Panzer 4 plus the Pack 40 and the Panzer Grenadier over the Panzer Shrek. This is going to be a close one there, I think, for Matthew. He's going to have to pull it off here versus Blitzkrieg, who otherwise does have quite an imposing force in terms of wrecking tanks. In fact, he's got a larger force population-wise here than Matthew, who's caught up there, the third Sherman. What they've been grabbed, supported here by an MD-42 heavy machine gun team. And we got a half-track for Blitzkrieg, a 251 half-track there, meeting those ships in Panzerwagen. Possibly for the flamethrower, might actually use it for reinforcement or even moving troops around the battlefield. That could be exciting. We'll of course have to see what Blitzkrieg does for the half track.
The enemy is taking what we have secured.
Well, there we go, 250 on half track out. Panzer is under fire from the Sherman as they get caught between them. Need to be careful there, need to be careful. Blitzkrieg, forsik. His unit penetration does seem to suffer a bit of his infantry. Other Sherman good to go. Oh, Tiger hits another mine! Tiger hits another mine! Oh, Blitzkrieg, you really need to get some mines from there. Panzer suffering more mine losses. They're almost getting wiped here. Need to fix up the Tiger. He's rushing his Panzer IV. I don't think he's quite paying attention to what's going on. Need to pull back the Panzer IV. Pulling up the Panzer IV, but still. Veteran 2 than the Sherman. Veteran 2. High rate of fire then than the Panzer IV now, definitely. Pulling them back for repairs again. Tiger needs some serious repairs as well. And the Panzer continue forward, but they're straight to the Strafniki, almost ready to flee. There you go. They do hit Veteran 2 flee. Quickly making short work of the several of the Panzer there, thanks to the SVT-40s and their flamethrowers. Sherman goes straight for the Tiger. There we go. Gets caught by it. Pack 40 setting up. Sherman then takes several hits. Panzer well going off. But continues there at the arc of fire. Killing several Pioneers in the process, by the way. Good work. Retreats one, not the low health one, but the full health of almost full numbers one there, surprisingly enough. Sherman continues up here. Panzer IV needs to deal with that as well. Nice armored handling there by Matthew. He didn't just, you know, bounce them up. He actually tried to attack from several points on around the same point. And there you go, gets the Panzer IV. Nasty loss there for Blitzkrieg. He's just sort of slightly dealing up one by one, but there you go. Veteran 2-2 on the target, increased accuracy, increased range. This is getting quite tense here. Who will pull this off? Who will win? I mean, one wrong move here, but he actually got... Oh! He got the Panzerjägers! He got the Panzergunners! That's going to cut off quite a bit there of anti-tank DPS for Blitzkrieg, you know, now with the Pack 40 and the Tiger. He could try and call in the Stuke here, but will he do it? and he's still facing off against now two Vets and two Shermans. Regular one as well, but overall three Sherman tanks here. If Matthew pulls off another well-coordinated armored attack here versus Blitzkrieg, he's going to win this. If he fumbles it, though, that of course will be Blitzkrieg's victory. So this could be a very decisive moment here. Both sides still have a very chance of a decent chance of winning, but it's going to come down to what they do. Oh. He's sending his half-damage Sherman on its own, but there might be a point to it. It serves as a distraction. It goes straight for the more vulnerable elements. It goes for the Mortar half attack with 40 kills, by the way. Can he get it? He's pushing his luck, though. Knocked out by the Tiger. It's increased range there. Basically knocking out there in the possibly spot here, but the half attack, in fact. We'll probably never know, but still, he can probably call in another Sherman soon enough anyways, but still, those are the two veteran Sherman crews here. No type Stuke here. Is he going for the Panzer IV then? What is Blitzkrieg planning here? Also needs to grab the other victory point as well as soon as possible. Quick grenade! Oh! Dear, he used the reconnaissance to spot out with being repaired and popped a bun grenade. What cheek! What a clever tactics there by Blitzkrieg, actually. More conscripts, but no Shermans. Just needs a bit of manpower, though. Those Shermans good to go as well. We got a Stuke on the way there for Blitzkrieg. Sturmgeschütz. Tiger still not fixed up. Third Sherman ready. And there we go. Oh, is he going to attack head on here, though? That's going to be pretty not wise, considering there's eventually two pack 40 with Tiger weak point. And the Tiger, of course, more tafting. We got Panzer under the air. Oh, he's going to look like that flank there. He's going to try and stay on, but still go past it. Circling about the pack 40 first, though. Tiger taking hits. Almost. There we go. He got the pack 40. He got the pack 40. MD42 going in from the front. They're clearing out any supporting elements. Tiger. Oh, sorry about that. Swiftly taking damage. Main gun knocked out. Sherman gets past it. Tiger's kaput. And there we go. Blitzkrieg surrenders. Pulled back. The Feldherrnhalle is gutted. Victory for the Soviet Union. Loss here for Germany. And what a fight. Here's some, I think, really good maneuvering there by Matthew. I would have liked to have made a better flank on this last fight. But overall, he was generally sort of pretty good at flanking, shifting, you know, axis for attack. Overall, the approach there to attacking, you know, constantly from time to time when it was necessary, rather than just keep bashing head on into Blitzkrieg with his guns were sighted. And repeatedly, he caught Blitzkrieg off guard there. Blitzkrieg, though, suffered a bit there from getting overconfident at times. But overall, he also played pretty well there with his pantsing under his strategy. I do think he should have half-track up soon to support, you know, Russia's troops about. The more half-track, though, was a surprisingly good choice there. Would not count on that, but good work there with that one, really. It's a good play there. But overall, Blitzkrieg, I think, got a bit too overconfident. Handled his summons units a bit too, you know, incautiously. Suffered a bit there from some awkward unit preservation, which overall gave the advantage to Matthew as the game progressed. But also could have done with more mines, for example, to help slow down some of the Shermans, that would also benefit the Blitzkrieg more. But again, I think a half-track sort of rushes troops about there would have helped a bit, and more Stugs. But also soon, I mean, that Stuge arrived too much late there when it could have been out there sooner to possibly support here. So there you go. But I hope you enjoyed this match. I hope you learned something from it. I hope it gives you different matches. If you did, want to subscribe, tell your friends, share it with everyone. If not, send me plenty of parts of feedback in the comment section. This is Imperial Link to Tears. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you all tomorrow for another exciting episode. Bye.